Matt Holly Campos. I'm from the Jefferson County JBS. I'm doing curriculum unit, and my theme is shapes and letters. This is my evidence of online summary. This is my FCCLA planning process page as my identify concerns, set a goal, and form a plan. My goal was to create 6 lesson plans that are developmentally appropriate for 3, 4, and 5-year-olds in our preschool. This is another planning process page. It's the act and the follow-up. My first lesson plan was science and sensory, shape one, bubbles. The strand was science, inquiry, and application. We made predictions. We used dish soap, glycerin, water, spoons, pipe cleaners, pencils. The child will be able to predict if the wands and the liquid will make bubbles. We washed hands to start off, and then I assigned each child a job and encouraged turn taking. I helped each child pour water into the bowl and gave each child a spoon and let them pour glycerin into the bowl. Last but not least, we added some dish soap in and we gave it some time to pour soap and mix, and then we took turns stirring. Then we made pipe cleaners and we made them with shapes. We used shapes to, we used pipe cleaners to create the shapes. And then once we had finished that, we made predictions if the bubble solution will work with our pipe cleaners. We experimented with our wands by dipping them in our bubble solution and blowing into them. If a student is hard hearing, I can always provide picture cards. This is my teacher evaluation. Holly did an excellent job with his science activity. The children enjoyed making the wands and blowing bubbles. They got to mix the homemade bubble solution before using it, and the wands took some time, but Holly was very impatient with the children. Good job, Holly. This is my assessment. Will the wand and liquid blow bubbles? My next lesson plan was language and literacy, and we did a letter match. This was a read-in and letter and word recognition. With modeling and support, we recognized the sounds associated with letters. We were given ABC match cards. The child will be able to match and identify upper and lowercase letters. We started off by singing the alphabet, and then we listened to a song on sounds associated with the letters of the alphabet. Then we took time to identify uppercase letters and lowercase letters. We matched lowercase letters and uppercase letters together, and the children identified the letters as they matched them. If a student has ADHD, I will give them a fidget toy. This is us listening to the phonics songs. We're getting an idea of the sounds associated with each letter. This is us matching letters together. And this is my assessment. They were able to match some of the letters, and then they were unable to match some of the letters. We put the capital letters and the lowercase up there too. My next lesson plan was creative arts. We did a fancy letter. It was motor development, small muscle, touch, grasp, reach, manipulate. We coordinated the use of hands, fingers, and wrists to manipulate objects and perform tasks requiring precise movements. They were given scissors, letter, paper, shapes, glue, and pencils. The child will be able to cut the letter and glue selected shapes. I showed them my example of the letter and then showed them paper shapes and asked what shapes they are. I had them cut out the first letter of their name and allowed them to glue shapes to their letters. The children will write their name on the back of the letter. If a child has difficulty using scissors, I can provide trained scissors where I put my fingers in the back of the scissors to help them cut. This is my assessment, whether you could hold scissors correctly or cut on the line. This is pictures of them cutting letters here and preparing to glue shapes. Fine motor, cardboard letter, roll. This was also a motor development with small muscle, touch, grasp, reach, manipulate, coordination of the use of the hands, fingers, and wrists to manipulate objects. We were given ABC cards, paint pens, dry erase markers, toilet paper rolls, and the dry erase board. The children will be able to dot the letters called out and write the letters on the dry erase board. First, we went over our ABCs using the ABC cards, and I demonstrated how to use the paint pens. Then I laid out the ABC cards and called out letters while the children found them. Children will dot the letter on their roll. And then we practiced writing letters on the dry erase board. If a student has ADHD, a wiggle stool can be provided. This is the finished product of the activity. This was them finding letters and matching them. This is me holding the letters up for them to find. And this is my assessment, whether you could hold pens correctly or find 3 out of 5 letters. my shape beanbag toss. This is a motor development. It's large muscle, balance, and coordination. It demonstrates skills with control, coordination, and balance during active play, running, hopping, skipping. We were given shape cards and beanbags. The children will be able to throw a beanbag to the shape called out. First, we sat down and we went through the shapes using shape cards. I named a letter they had to find on the carpet and they had to go stand on it. Then I laid out shape cards on the floor and I gave each child a beanbag. I cut out a shape and had them tossed to the beanbag, or tossed to the shape that I had asked for. Once they could not process what shape I may be talking about, I had another card in my hand and they could look at it and determine that, and that's their visual reminder. If a student is disabled and uses a wheelchair, I could push them to the spot needed and give them a larger target if needed. This is us reviewing shapes with my visual reminder. This is me giving demonstrations and directions. And this is my assessment, if you could hit the targeted shapes. This is my rubric. And then last but not least, I have my math-builded shapes. It's geometry. We identify and describe shapes. Understand and use names of shapes when identifying objects. We use shape cards and Play-Doh. The children will be able to make shapes out of Play-Doh. We watched the shape song video, and then I laid out shape cards and had the children pick which ones they may want to use. And then they had made the shape out of Play-Doh. If my student has autism, we can work one-on-one. This is us making shapes together. They already did a few of them. They made a star. They made a diamond. And this is my assessment. You had to make a circle, triangle, star, diamond, rectangle, or square. Where the X's are is if you could make it, and where they're not is where you couldn't make. This is my evidence of developmental knowledge, language and cognitive milestones, emotional and social development, movement milestones, and hands and finger skills. For my standard, I picked outcome 5.1, curriculum planning. Develop curriculum that ensures learners receive integrated, coherent learning experiences. When developing these six lesson plans, I ensure children receive coherent learning experiences by using Ohio's development standards to plan my lessons. In conclusion, when doing this project, I improved my problem-solving skills. How I did this was when working with the children, I strengthened my skills because I needed to teach in different ways.